So this is the Game On Asshole Tournament 2016, and
awesome name.
Yeah, I think you like that because you made it.
Kinda.
And of course, I am Tim Beck, and joining me
is RR.
Yeah, I was gonna say introduce yourself.
Yeah.
So. Oh, there we go. Okay, so I just scroll up a little bit.
So this is the pools, right?
I'm sorry?
This is the pools.
The pool.
Oh, no. This is the round robin thing, right?
Oh, no. Okay, so the deal was I had this tournament set up for 32 people to do a Swiss set on the first... it's like a round robin, but instead of playing everybody, you play kind of most people. So we had a Swiss setup for today, and it was going to be double elimination finals with the 8 finalists tomorrow. However, we had low turnout, which actually I'm very grateful for, because no pressure on me for trying to do with the tournament, and I learned a few things along the way. So,
and it's the first tournament for us, but
right,
that would be perfect.
Oh yeah, so nobody, and it was no pressure. We had a lot of fun in Discord and everything while we were doing it. But that being said, I decided because of low turnout to drop it to just today and just do the double elimination, and it turned out to work really great. Everybody had to play about 2 or 3 games in total, which was what I wanted it to be. Yeah. Okay, so this first game is between... and if you want to see details on the tournament, you can go to yolo420.com/goat2016. And there's the brackets there and everything if you want to see how everything actually ended up laying out here. But since I was able to record it, RR and I are going to do this.
Yeah. Just stick with us, and we'll be sticking on this too.
So I'm going to start this, and like I said, this is Spaff and Diego-centric, and it took me a second to get everybody spectated, so we are about a turn into this game. And this is I was only able to spectate the winner's matches up until the end, when I was able to spectate the end of the loser's bracket. So these are all winner's bracket matches for the most part.
Cool.
Well, this can be turned up a little bit.
Oh, okay. Sorry. Nice move.
There you go.
So, Whirlwind. Now he's thinking it's... Yeah?
Go. Yeah. All right.
Whoa, Whirlwind. All right. You. Oh, typical chat realm.
Yeah, got the BJC
right
click. BJC is representing strong. You know, Flame Imp has never been one of my favorites in Zoo, just because I hate drawing it late.
Yeah, but this early is so awesome. There's 1 to 4 mana. Okay. 7.
Yeah.
Okay, that's pretty much awesome. You can hit. Oh,
hey, look at net outcome though.
He's taunting it up. That's right. Acolyte will be awesome here.
Yeah, you put out the
Whirlwind.
The
yeah,
you're the warrior here. You've got all kinds of time. The warlock is the one that's got to put the pressure on you. And to be honest with that board, like his net result is that now he's still behind in life. Which is, you know, granted, it's early in the game, so life is your resource. But he's also behind on cards. And while he's ahead on the board at the moment, we all know how that works against Warrior.
Yeah, he wants control of the board. Yeah. But there's still pretty much a limit how you would control the board.
Well, true. But, I mean, if you're going to pick any class to make a control class out of, you pick Warrior.
Yeah.
Warrior.
Okay, slamming that down.
Yep, that's a smart one. Because I mean, it's only got one health.
Hitting that chief. Hello. Yes.
And a nice full clear.
Whirlwind. All right.
Yeah.
Okay. You can't put that... the three mana thing there.
Darkshire Councilman.
Yep, that's right.
Yeah. I wouldn't do that yet.
It's pretty late.
Yeah, I like what he's doing right here, loading up his hand.
Right.
And as
unloading,
you can see,
yeah, unloading his hand.
Yeah, as you can see, I did my best on kind of trying to flip the cards around so you can see everything with what I could do with one spectator account.
Right. Oh, Sea Giant.
Yeah, it's still not very threatening. I mean, 8 mana is a lot.
Right, but... Okay, control the board. That's an important minions for the Warlock.
And I'll be honest, even though I watched a lot of these games, parts of it, you know, I might have run out to grab food or to pee or to, you know, whatever. So I just forgot what has happened in the games because I watched so many of them. But...
Okay. Huh. Zeus Initiate, huh?
That's a pretty unused card.
Pretty unused card.
That one and Spawn of N'Zoth. I tried to make a deck around those, a Death Rattle deck, and I couldn't quite make it work. I mean, it had its moments, but it just wasn't there.
Yeah.
By the way, Spawn of N'Zoth is the one that has, I believe it's a 2/2 with Death Rattle of give all your minions +1/+1.
Minions 1/+1, yeah.
Yeah. It's pretty It's pretty raw when you get it to go off the right way.
I think he need to put some... Yeah.
Yep. Keep putting the pressure on.
And add the 0 mana spell to cast all of your...
Do this.
Or the Sea Giant, yeah. No! Okay.
Actually, okay. Well, I was going to say you should put down the Defender of Argus before you put down the Sea Giant, but if you're going to trade a minion away first... Yeah, okay. I'm trying to figure out. I'm like, why would you trade that minion away? Oh, sorry. Oh. Don't mind me trying to get friends list set up correctly. you'll see people signing on and off too. Sorry.
Seven damage.
Yep. Bit solid.
Oh, Malkin Rock. That's a great card.
Is the volume coming through a little loud for you?
No, it's perfect.
Okay. Just want to make sure I'm not drowning you out.
Right. What's happening?
My shield for Argus. Try to save your ass, basically, right? That's what you're doing right now.
Six. But yeah, Makarok on this pretty clear stage.
Yeah. Depending on what he gets, it could. Alright.
Oh, it's perfect.
Yep.
That's awesome.
And I suppose you could even Blood to Ichor if you wanted, but I wouldn't.
No. Armor up.
Yeah.
Let him come to you. Tap.
So yeah, if you're in Diego's shoes here, this doesn't look so great.
It's panic mode, right, yeah. Because you're losing life fast and the warrior guy has a weapon.
Yeah, he's got a weapon, and he's just going to keep armoring himself up. Like, you can even hit him for 8. That's probably okay.
Yeah. Or dropping Rag.
Right. And,
he doesn't care.
And he's gonna, of course, shore up his chances here to make it a 50-50 with the Rag.
Will the RNG gods help him?
Pray to RNG Jesus.
Jesus!
Oh! Well, I mean...
Kept it close, yeah.
Yeah, that's one of those 50-50s that either one was good.
Yeah.
Yeah, that Possessed Villager art is so good on the golden cards.
Ooh, fancy.
Alright. I mean, if he can hold him off...
He could.
Like, so his Rag now is like a 20% chance to hit, or even less.
Less. Yes, lesser. Ifer.
Yasu, okay, well, when he takes that out, it'll be 20% chance to hit.
Okay, so, praying to RNG Jesus again.
Yep, 1 in 5 to take the game up.
Oh, wow!
Nice. Oh, nice, man. Map.
RNG Jesus answered your prayer.
Right? So, man, that was a good game.
Pretty fast, interesting, too. It's pretty one-sided, though, in the first few mana turns that, this looks like the warrior has an advantage here.
Yeah, a little bit. I'm just jumping us forward a little bit.
And that warrior doesn't finish up his minion topping in his board, and always controlled by the warrior.
Yeah, the warlock never did establish board control. Super solid. I guess he did have board control for a fair amount of the match, but it wasn't consequential. The warrior was able to answer the warlock's board control every time. So
right, and having the whirlwind on the early part of his hand is pretty great.
Right. Super helpful again. I mean, if I'm ever playing like Patron again and I come up against a Warlock, I usually keep Whirlwind in my opening hand just to make sure if it's a zoo, I've got my ass covered. You know.
Yeah. So okay. So he changed decks now and he's playing a priest.
Yep, we are playing a best of five conquest format. So the winner must keep or must change their decks. They basically in order to win the match, you have to win with each one of your non-banned decks. So each player...
So Blizzard rules, yeah.
Yep, Blizzard rules for their tournaments. Although they may be looking at last year's standing more heavily soon. Because it's also right, yeah. Very, very good. But basically, each player brought four decks to the tournament. And in a match, each player then banned one of the other player's decks. And so they're left with three, which they need to win with each one of.
The light shall burn you.
Ooh, turn two, heal the opponent's
edgy.
Face.
Ooh, edgy.
It's a bold play, Cotton. Let's see how it works out for him. My blade be
thirsty. Okay. Nope, he doesn't have a Shadow Word thing. Yeah, Doomsayer will be okay here.
Solid move.
Yeah.
Because he could put out 5-6 damage if he wanted, but... Oh no!
Yeah,
he can take him out.
He can take him out. Yeah.
Yeah. Slam. Winax. Bump. It looks like he might just
Winax.
Do that. Oh, maybe he won't. Okay.
Oh. Yeah.
And, you know, this is fine too.
It's fine. I think he's not committing to too many cards for one, Doomsayer.
Right.
But Harrison Jones.
That sucks. Because he didn't even get to use it once. Like that's
right.
Kind of at least that's usually the consolation.
Yeah, he didn't
prize.
Put the three damage in. That's horrible.
Yeah, you know when you have a two durability weapon, that's usually like the consolation prize to Harrison Jones is that you've already used up one of those. So you're like, okay, well, you know, you only killed half of it. But, man, just to lose your whole thing, that sucks. That's basically just erased his turn, too.
Yeah. Now he's thinking about maximizing this instance. Could he Elise?
I think it's a little early. Like, you could against this, but there's a lot of removal that the warrior has. I just don't... Excuse me. I just don't know if Elise is enough of a threat at this point.
I think it's just setting the board for your condition ahead. I think I saw Trump doing it because he needs to have his condition already bump up.
That's true. Give yourself more turns to draw that map.
Yeah.
What's he gonna do here? I mean... you know, Diego's got his work cut out for him. He could just, yeah, as I say, the Harrison. And then what do you want to do? Slam, you could slam execute, or you could, I don't know if I want to execute that, though.
No.
But you don't want to leave it either.
True.
I guess, yeah, just...
Yeah.
Armor up face, and he's not getting through the taunt, at least.
Oh.
Well, okay. I take back my previous statement.
Yeah, you can... He can hit...
Although, I don't know if I do this.
No, you can hit the taunted... The taunt, and...
Yeah, you could bump it and do excavated evil. Oh, yeah, you could heal. Yeah. No, you don't have enough mana.
No, the flash heal.
Oh, okay. Well, see, then you're using flash heal for 2 health, though. And that's kind of, that always kind of feels bad, man. Yeah, it's an awkward turn.
Yeah, it's an awkward turn. Oh, yeah.
Oh.
To do that.
Yeah, no, that's
actually... That's 5, yeah. But... Yeah. For me, death is so much precious because I know the warrior has bigger minions to use that, but
right.
Hey.
But this actually, I like the way he ended up playing that out because now he's left, he got another card out of the deck and he was able to heal
a very lucky weapon.
Wow, that's
very lucky.
Two in a row that we've gotten True Silver Champion from Nalcarak.
Oh, True Heart.
Okay, this nice. Could end up as a long game.
Okay. 2, yeah.
Well, I mean, I guess we can count ourselves lucky that this Tempo Warrior doesn't have Jessicar.
Jessicar, yeah. Yeah, slam hit.
Yep.
And arm up.
Maybe drop your Corcron? Yeah, get him out there, get some damage in.
Right.
The board's empty, so you might as well.
Sure. Soul Priest. That's too early.
Yeah, you don't really have anything to... I mean, you don't want to circle Akanai circle this board.
Yeah, I think this is a Elise time. Time for Elise.
Yeah, yes. I'm kind of inclined to agree. I can't think of anything else I'd want to do.
He's very inclined to kill this Glarkron.
Yeah, so he's probably thinking...
I don't approve.
Yeah, he's thinking he's going to whirlwind... he's going to whirlwind Akanai. Yeah, ping. Man.
But
okay.
It's like...
I don't know if I like that.
No. Because he could Grommash or something. Hit that and...
Well, Grommash is only 4.
Oh, right. Yeah, I forgot.
But still.
Whoa! Wow, really?
Whoa!
For Akanai.
Yeah, that's an overreaction. I mean, I know you've got 2 in your hand.
That's an overreaction because you don't have a board yet and you're still killing it with
here. Yeah, I kind of don't like that.
Do you have the audience? Yeah, it's the least turn, yeah?
Yeah.
It's kind of late with that, but... well,
you're right, it's been time to drop her for a while. Because you're not... making a ton of headway in this match as the priest. Like, yeah, you've got 1 thing on the board and you've got maybe 2 card advantage on in play.
Okay.
It's warrior, right? They can come back pretty easy.
Yeah. Okay.
That's always been my experience with warrior that I hate. Like, when I just hate them the most, I get them down to like 3 health. And then all of a sudden, I spend the next 20 turns with trying to kill this damn...
Trying to get off their armor, yeah.
Right? And in the end, they fatigue me. They're like, oh, you're just a jerk.
Patient bastards.
I suppose I can't talk, because I used to do that to people with the old Murloc Paladin, too. Just wait, heal,
oh,
wait,
that
wait, heal.
Murloc Paladin is very, very frustrating. Not, it's not a lot of patience, but a lot of, hey, I'm a troll, I'm trolling you with this deck.
See, I love to play it when the whole ladder was Secret Paladin, though. Because you can't play against it like you would a Secret Paladin. And that's how everyone first interprets it.
Yeah, the Yomi of the Paladin Murloc thing is either Secret or pure Murloc. And that often makes it to your favor because they're committing to mistakes that maybe works on a Secret Paladin but not on a Murloc Paladin.
Yeah, it's like playing Warlock, right? Is he Zoo? Is he Handlock? Is he Reno? These things
yeah,
matter.
Warlock's pretty hard to read on the first mana stages. Yeah,
for a little while. It's pretty tough to tell what they are.
Okay. Okay,
you're gonna... Okay, I like this, though.
Yeah,
you're gonna
yeah.
beef her up.
Yeah. Oh, he's on the Zot deck. But how many Death Rider cards do you have?
Yeah. You just as soon as you said that, I was like, I don't think I've seen that many Death Rattles. He's got that one, it's a Shade. I forget what it's called.
Yeah,
steals another
getting,
card from them.
Yeah, steals another card from your deck.
Yeah, so he's got one of those. I don't remember anything else, though.
Hmm.
I mean, granted, it looks like they've still both got plenty of deck, so... In life, I mean, at the moment, life and card in hand versus board, they look about even.
Right, so and I
there's
think
an Akhenai Circle
15?
Turn.
Yeah. No, Excavate Feet Evil is perfect here.
Oh yeah. Shoot, I missed that one out. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Because you're gonna want to.
My thing is getting fancy. Don't go fancy on this.
No. You're gonna want to save your Akhenai for Flash Heal.
No, I think he's thinking Pyromancer shit. But no, don't get fancy on this.
No, you don't want to give him an extra draw. Yeah, just activate
yeah,
and evil that.
Yeah, he's thinking about it, but no, it's not great.
No, do that, drop your Northshire, and then use your Wild Pyromancer next turn to cause a little bit of damage, even to yourself, that you can heal. And you know, get some cards off your Northshire. At least that's kind of my opinion of this.
I don't think we know what warrior hit is this.
It's basically a tempo warrior, but it's got some tech cards that make it
Does
a little
he have
bit later.
Patrons?
No, I haven't seen. I mean, at least we haven't seen any.
Yeah.
That's basically what tempo warrior is, though, right? It's patron just without the patrons. you realize
it kind of sucks. Yeah. This kind of sucks without that condition, though.
Right, but you do have a lot more conditions. You end up giving yourself more in the end, because you have Malkorok, you have Grom, which you would have had before, but then you also throw in Rag, and then, you know, you have your Executes that you can keep yourself clean for. The reason this deck came about is because people were playing Patron and going, I could probably replace these Patrons with X card at 5 mana, and it would be fine. Like, the rest of this deck works out against the meta right now, because you're fighting a lot of Zoo, you're fighting a lot of Aggro Paladin, you're fighting a lot of Nazoth Paladin, where you're, you know, kind of big board type things.
Right.
So, I don't know.
Yeah. But losing the Patron loses the Yomi of you spaz out the... your opponent on what are you doing or what are you what's your end game,
right?
Basically, it's just adding more end game conditions on your part.
No, you're right. It does very much help you keep the board, especially because you start forcing them to trade into things that you don't have to pay mana to put out.
Right.
Ooh, he's gonna want Shifting Shade.
Anubis setup.
Yep.
Shifting Shade. All right. But Anubis is pretty awesome too.
Yeah.
If you have the board for it.
Right. As it looks though, I mean, this is perfect because you've got Nazoth. Don't. Okay. I was going to say, don't cast.
Don't flash heal.
What would you flash heal like? Whatever you're thinking of doing, don't do it.
Your skills are great. Oh, Varian. I didn't notice him.
Okay.
That's
another card
what,
that's
does
been
he
included.
Pull out?
He's got a Battle Rage, he's got a Frothing Berserker, and a Ravaging Ghoul.
Oh, that's not good.
No, he would have preferred to draw the Ravaging Ghoul at this point.
Yeah.
I mean, look at the armor rolling in from this. Like, he would have been able to have, 8 armor just off of dropping the Ravaging Ghoul. It would have been solid.
And now the plea or the problem of the priest that doesn't have the AoE now.
Yeah, because he doesn't have Excavator Evil back in his hand.
Yeah. So I think here he should have kept some of the AoE.
Yeah, it might have. See, the problem is though, the points that he did use his AoE, it seemed appropriate. So
right,
I don't...
but it's very very awkward. Because...
Yeah.
Okay.
He still does have Akanai Circle though, so he can soften up. Like he, okay, well, I was about to say he could use that Arathi to soften up the Varian, but that's not going to work that way. Do you Malkara?
I have no time for games.
Oh, okay, yeah, you're going to steal.
Yeah.
Smart. Like it. I like it.
And don't dance it, priest.
Circle.
Don't dance it yet.
Okay.
You're not in the clear.
Oh! Did he draw that much? I didn't realize he pulled that much off Battle Rages.
Yeah. Yeah, because, yeah, I saw that and execute. That's right.
And then, what next turn drop Rag? GG.
Right. GG. Either heal up.
Let's see, if he drops Nazoth, he doesn't have any taunts, right? It's just the two Shades and Sylvanas.
Sylvanas, yeah. Just heal up, yeah.
Double heal, alright, so you're gonna make it to next turn at least.
Yeah, but still dropping on 18.
Yeah, Curator, get something else for the Nazoth to pull out?
Why? No!
Malkara?
No, you'll be killed. But... Okay, we're saying it because.
Oh,
we
this
don't
is
know.
Genius!
Oh, okay. But still.
Oh, I love that. No, I like that move.
Still, but it's not in the clear yet.
Yeah, no, it's not. It's still. That was. I definitely give him props for the Circle of Healing to drop six on.
Yeah. But still, yeah, I saw that Blood to Icar and still, it's hitting with big damage. Excavate Evil.
Yeah, well, I mean, now you would Malkarok. Yeah, Malkarok to the Gromash and excavated the board away. And then what? Museum Curator, Heal Face?
Yeah. Need a dead right out of it now.
I'm almost thinking I would have Museum Curated first. Chillmall.
Oh, it's Chillmall. Yeah, Chillmall.
You need that taunt. There you go. As I say, I almost would have Museum Curated first just in case there's something I could have casted instead for 3 mana and that I may have wanted to cast instead of healing myself. But it's probably
Rag
a good thing
the
he
face.
Didn't.
Rag in the face. Oh man, you're ragged in the face. Okay. Chillmall.
Yeah, that's...
For 50. Okay. He could do that too.
Oh, okay. He's lessening his chances.
Yep.
Or raising his chances of living.
Time to pray to RNG Jesus.
Yeah, it's a 1 in 5. It's definitely 20% chance after this. Oh, never mind. It's a 1 in 3.
3.
Oh, shit. What?
Wow. Yeah, he's...
He just can... Oh, okay. Yeah. Oh, I guess he had no... Yeah.
Yeah.
No cards. Damn. That's crazy.
That's crazy. That's a big turnaround for Spap.
Yeah. That was so good. Oh, man. So I guess that was really he had a 1 in 3 chance to win or a 1 in 3 chance to absolutely lose. Because, if it went like it did That's and you stole the Ragnarok because you... Ragnaros, because you killed the Sylvanas with Ragnaros. Oh, man. Crazy good.
I think Zot is pretty great on point on that turn.
Yeah. No, that was actually very smart because you need to dilute your chances of being hit by that fireball.
But knowing the deck of the priest, I think he doesn't stock up on death rattle minions too much.
Yeah.
It's like an aside to his deck.
Yeah, he actually pulled most of those from Museum Curators. Your soul
shall be mine. It's a viable strategy, but I think he needs to more stock up on death rattle minions just to start off.
Yeah.
I
might leave a Chill Maw in the deck.
Yeah. Chill Maw, what's this? Cairn.
This is game 3. And right. We have 2 wins to Spaff right now. So this is match point.
Mm-hmm. Flame him. Is there a question here? Okay.
And it looks like we've got a Reno lock against that tempo-ish warrior that we saw. It's funny, tempo warrior and tempo mage have both, tempo warrior wasn't a thing, but...
Yeah.
They're both slower than their names would suggest.
Or not a tempo deck, maybe a slow swing deck?
Yeah, something.
A warrior swing or something.
Yeah, that's because it is. I mean, you've got so many high level character or high mana minions, and it's the same to be honest with the latest tempo mage, where you have maybe a Cabalist Tome in there, or you have Yogg-Saron, of course, and Ragnaros.
Yeah,
or
almost all spells basically for a couple of minions.
Yeah. So, I'm just getting into this here with this Reno lock.
Okay, pump up the Berserker here.
Yeah, I was going to say, I would go there and then... I mean, I suppose you could have Battle Raged first.
Oh yeah, that's right.
Oh no, Battle Raged, Berserker wasn't hurt.
Huh? Oh yeah, forgot.
Yeah, Berserker wasn't hurt, so yeah, you should Battle Rage there.
Elf.
Yeah, face Hellfire.
Huh. Twisting Mirror, huh? That's a weird card to have.
Oh, not in Reno Lock.
Huh. Oh, right. Reno Lock, yeah.
Yeah, because you need to clear that board probably right around turn 8.
Not Doom?
No, nobody runs Doom. And I don't know why. Why you wouldn't...
Yeah, it's the same thing as Nether, but...
Isn't it
gives you cards.
It's 2 more mana, though. Let me look here.
Slam, yeah. Slam.
Oh, there you go. Slam Arathi kill.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, Doom is 10 mana. Maybe that's the difference?
card draw is much better?
No.
It's like a dead turn if innate, right?
See, and then that's hard too, right? Do you want the card draw or not? Your Reno deck, you're meant to last a long time. Do you want to push yourself into fatigue?
Hmm.
Like, if you doom for 5 cards, that's significant.
Okay, yeah.
I don't know. I agree, though. In my opinion, I would replace Twisting Nether with Doom. But maybe there's some... I mean, there's also a reason why I'm not a professional Hearthstone player.
Yeah, me neither. Hmm. Why are we doing this?
You know, it's fun.
It's fun. It's fine. It's fine.
So, what do you do? Do you put out your Reno here?
Yeah.
Coming back as Spath, like, do you put out... Because he's going to hurt you.
Yeah. Yeah, that's 4.
Yeah, I'd tap Reno. Oh, no, you can't tap even, because... Yeah, just Reno.
Reno. Don't be cocky there.
Well, you know, I like to see the BJC represented here.
But hey, it's cocky.
Yeah. There's actually the emotes in the games have been pretty tasteful. You know, a little jabby, yeah. Like that one was, you know. A little stab at him, but they're always very good.
Yeah, I think the thing that arrives. Oh, good here.
Yeah, you need to get rid of that board. Still such a cool animation.
Rag.
Yeah, I can't think of anything else I'd do.
That's a kill, actually. Well. Oh, he did it. Really? He didn't kill the... Didn't hit him for 3? Huh.
Maybe he's expecting to have to kill something? I can kind of understand holding it for removal. He's already used Reno, though. You would have put him at 1 health.
Yeah.
Well, right, this works too.
That's a weird turn. Oh, that's awesome.
Oh, wow.
Yeah. Nice pulling out the top. Nice third variant. Okay. I have no time for games. Yeah.
The old Sylvanas steal.
Now, yeah, I think he's now regretting not hitting him with 1. Bringing down the Warlock to 1.
Yeah, because then, I mean, he'd be dead.
Yeah. Right?
Look, well, I guess, no, right? he did heal with Refreshment Vendor, so he'd still be
able. Yeah, but still close.
I mean, aside from Curse Blade, I think that's kind of the only other one you don't want to see.
That's a horrible card. Yeah, faceless.
Oh, is this GG? Yeah. No. He doesn't.
No,
have
no,
health
not
yet.
Yeah.
I was thinking faceless with Leroy, but I was like, no, he doesn't have enough damage yet. But I do like the faceless on Malkorok because you're able to take the board back and present a significant board back to them.
And Malkorok is not damage.
Right. Yeah, that's the other advantage. You're able to snag him at full health.
Okay.
Is this just he didn't know what else to do?
Can he? Armor up. Okay. I think he's searching for Whirlwind. Oh, okay.
I'm sure, yeah. That or Ravaging, works. Or... Yeah, there you go.
That works.
Yeah, with a second armor spin.
Yeah.
Insult to injury, man.
Now he needs a... a better weapon? Oh no, it's GG if Grommash drops.
Yeah, it's GG unless Baf can finish the game right now. And he's got, what, 6 from Leroy? He could do
6 from Leroy
7
and...
if he did Protector.
Protector.
13.
What are you doing?
He has a max of 16. Okay.
Oh, he's doing the defend my shit before.
Yeah, he's gonna make a taunt wall. Although, having played lately quite a bit of mid range, Hunter.
Warrior.
Hunter. I know a lot about that because on turn 7, you set up right because turn 8 you're dropping that Call of the Wild. And so if you have a taunt up and you can keep a couple minions out, when you put that Call of the Wild out, boom, game over.
Yeah, calling the bros.
I like
calling the bros at 8.
Yeah, I like unleash the dudes.
Unleash the dudes. what is his play here?
Yeah, this is kind of turned right around. Because he doesn't have anything he can do. You know, smart, yeah, get his damage up. But...
yeah.
Yeah, you're kind of screwed here. And now he's got, what,
that's
9?
Awkward.
12?
Yeah, Leroy could have killed him right now if...
No, he's 18. With
Leroy. Oh, 18!
Because Leroy's 6, right? Oh shit, Leroy power overwhelming is 10, 17, 19.
Yeah,
I'm up for him. Oh, he's so close. 17, 19, 22, right. And he needs to get 23. Alright.
Okay.
Keep the game.
Yeah. Grummy.
Okay. Making the smart trades.
Right. Yes, you have more cakes. Okay. Spellbreaker. Spellbreaker that... your magic shall not... I predict... yeah?
Yeah, and then you can clean up the board on their side, because you're just trying to live right now.
Yeah.
Because you've got Leroy Power Overwhelming ready whenever you've got that the extra damage to finish it off.
Yeah, I think he needs to taunt up on this. Needs to taunt or...
yeah, he definitely... he may not feel like he needs to, though. I mean, 25 health, you feel pretty comfortable.
But still, it's a warlock we were talking about here.
True, true. I mean, you know you're up against... there you go, yeah. You know you're up against Arena Lock,
yeah.
And they're kind of... they kind of do that Leroy Faceless combo anymore.
Yeah. Well... okay. But still, he has a Black Knight. That's why.
Yep. That Black Knight value. Man.
He came a comeback right now. I think Blizzard...
oh, shit.
Knows. Oh.
What were you going to say, though?
I think Blizzard really intended to make a comeback for the Black Knight. Because knowing the structure now of Shaman with the taunts and such. Yeah.
Is this game over? 10, 14, 16, 20.
Yeah. It's game.
Oh, 20. Yep, yeah, 22.
Yeah, it's game.
What am, oh, no. Double from the brand.
Yeah.
That's only 22, not 23, but nope. It's actually 25. Or 24, whatever. One more.
Four. still.
Yeah, I forgot double from the brand on the abusive.
Brand, yeah.
All right, wow.
So what's the score here?
So that's 3-0 on Spaff's part. He's wow. Wins.
Wins.
Yeah, so he takes now. The first one out. And let me look at the bracket here, see where we're going next. I believe I go to, Al-Anon 6666 and Whiskey Wolf. So this, should I spoil things?
Yeah, these sure tip.
Okay, so I'm sure we all realize this was pre-recorded. My first tournament doing things, so it worked out much, much easier this way. But it's cool to be able to cast it, too. I'm really enjoying this. The ones that are going to the grand finals that'll be at during CreateCon, I will be there, but neither contestant will be there, so we'll figure out a way to cast that. The two that are going to be competing on July 30th are Whiskey Wolf and Al-Anon. So we're kind of seeing a preview of what might be the finals as well, because they did face off once in the tournament.
Huh.
Let's see if I can jump us forward a little bit here. Find the start point of that. Like I said, there's some dead time between these. Oops. Let's.
Ooh.
There we go. Okay. It should be starting soon. Yeah, there's a little bit of dead time between these as people pick decks and all that good junk. And I don't have the licenses to put music between it like they do on ESL or, to play Hearthstone Twitch channel or whatever.
Well. There's a friend of ours that we could ask for music.
That is true. For live ones, we will definitely be doing that.
Right.
When we're doing live casting.
Sure. Huh.
So, we got Al-Anon versus
my favorite class.
Rogue?
Yeah.
I've
Rogue versus Mage.
I've just not been able to get the knack of Rogue myself.
It's very, very... What's this? Multi-branch thinking.
Yeah, it's very different. You gotta imagine multiple possibilities.
Right. So now you don't. Yeah.
Yep. Skip. Yep. Pass.
Pass.
Skip.
No, don't do it. Come on.
He's
no.
Probably just life coaching. Just thinking of the. Later turns.
Wow. Whoa. You're sassy.
Whoa. What was that card he just drew?
That's Frostbolt.
No, the card he just drew, it'd be on the left.
That's the
Twilight Dragon.
Twilight Dragon.
What?
This is, I think, a Dragon Mage.
See, I thought this was tempo from... I mean, like, you know, you put out your Mana Worm, and then you have your Arcane Intellect on turn 3, and your turn 2 Frostbolt. Like, this is tempo mage.
But, weirdly, it has a taunt.
Yeah, what the fuck is that dragon doing there? All right.
Okay, killing that thing over there.
Of course,
you can't kill it.
If this were 2 months ago... Polymorph would be out of the question to have in a tempo mage, but that's kind of a staple nowadays.
I'd much better have the polymorph boar thing.
Yes, I actually use that more too. I use one of each currently. Because it depends on what you're doing, right? Sometimes you need to bore your own character, you know, your own minion.
For extra damage, that's right.
Yeah.
Fan.
Yeah, fan for the draw, or okay, you're gonna build up your weapon.
You're hit him in the face.
I mean, you could, but you usually want to save that extra charge for deadly poison, or you know that extra deadly poison charge. You kind of want to save it.
Oh, a dragon mage, huh?
This must be. He's got Blackwing Technician in there.
Okay.
Dude,
Oh.
Whiskey Wolf, dude, you rock.
Yeah.
Bringing some cool decks. Sinister Strike, the the Blackwing Technician.
That's why it's a classic matchup, because Rogue has now this to kill anything that over 5 withheld. And makes the Priest Rogue matchup pretty bearable.
Twilight Guardian. I'm sorry, I said Twilight Dragon before. Twilight Guardian. Yeah. I couldn't remember the names. There's so many.
Prep? We could prep. Eviscerate.
Yeah, you what? Prep Eviscerate Zarl? So but he's not or even dead. Even no, if you fan. Huh? Prep Eviscerate Fan is
that's
still
five,
only 5.
Right? Oh, right.
So I mean, you could face tank Prep Eviscerate. You wouldn't even need to prep at that point. Well, you would.
He would.
Face tank Blood Mage? Yeah, I was just going to say Blood Mage Eviscerate? Like, get a minion out?
Yeah, Blood Mage, yeah. That makes 5, hit. Yeah, this does eat prep.
It sucks a little bit. It sucks a little bit that you're burning up your one of your poison death charge or poison blade charges, but or I'm sorry, deadly poison charges. Yeah. I forgot poison blade is also a weapon.
Cold Dara Drake.
Yeah, Cold Dara Drake. That's like I don't care who you are. That's not played. You know what I mean? Have you ever seen that come out?
No. I think the first time I saw it is the what's this? The first time it be seen in the deck is within the first few weeks of the adventure pack. No.
Was that TGT? Or
TGT.
Was...
Yeah, TGT.
Or was Caldera League? I think it was TGT.
Yeah. So.
Yeah, and maybe the occasional arena run.
Right. Or a challenge.
Oh, sure, yeah.
Yeah, the challenge in the TGT.
Oh, man, can you imagine Caldera Drake with the one that reduces your. In that two card brawl? Caldera Drake with the one that reduces your hero power cost?
Right.
That'd be awesome. It's still not as good as Innervate Yashiraj, though.
Wow, yeah. Alright, that's right.
Yep, Torch Pin, face. And probably nothing else.
Oh, Bent Leaf.
And yeah, he's got the hand to start doing some business, too. If he draws a gadget... Yeah, see, he really wants a gadget, Zan, to make this work, but...
No dice.
You know, he might even... Okay, yeah. Yeah, draw that card first.
Draw a card.
I was going to say, he might even Tomb Pillager and Shiv so that the Caldera Drake dies if he wants to kill the Tomb Pillager. And then he also still gets his coin while he's still hoping for his gadget Zan.
But it makes him much more vulnerable to a kill because... It makes him his health lower. You know we're dealing with a mage here.
Well, right. No, I was just saying you. Oh yeah, because then you leave yourself up into the Caldera Drake just being able to go face.
Yeah.
I was thinking you Shiv put out Tomb Pillager because then if the Caldera Drake attacks the Tomb Pillager, he's dead.
Oh, interesting. Yeah, pull out the Drake.
I guess go for it.
Oh no, big damage here.
Oh yeah, and you just drew Chilmaw too, man. This mage could just kill this off ready, like not quite right here, but oof, it doesn't matter.
Six
that good.
Plus 12 and 2.
He doesn't have the other 3 damage. Like
we can make it close to 1 because of Caldera Drake. Fireball.
Yeah, he could do it twice.
Yeah, twice.
Yeah, he could fireball. What is it called? Flame blast is technically what the hero power is called, but yeah.
Yeah, flame blast.
Yeah, fireball, ping, ping.
What to do? What to do?
Or another Caldera Drake? Okay, okay.
Okay, you're getting fancy here.
Well,
why?
No, I see what he's trying to lock the win, right? He knows he's got that fireball, so he's just got to get him down to a point where he can get 6 more damage on him. And if he's got 12 on the board, you know, even if you deal with one of those, you only have to draw 2 more damage next draw to win. And in a mage deck, that's not hard.
But still. Okay. What's in the box?
Then what not do you start helpful. Doing? Do you... Okay, so you shiv to take him out. Let's see what else we get. Yeah, Van Cleef? Oh, no. Oh!
Still.
Wouldn't you want
knowing the mage card... Yeah, still no dice.
Wouldn't you want to prep there?
Yeah.
I would have prepped for more damage on the Van Cleef. Prep, I don't know, toxin or something. It doesn't matter, you know, 2 more cards.
But still, he has so much damage on him, which is pointless to a mage, because if you're down 15, the mage can kill you.
Right. He's just got to make sure he's got the right burn in hand.
Right.
And that's the thing, too, is Whiskey Wolf didn't use up any of his burn taking out the board, really.
True.
I guess that's what the dragons are for. Interesting.
Right, the stall.
Yeah, you board control with dragons, and then you hold off the... Man, the more and more I talk about this deck, the more I like it. I'm not so hot on the Caldera Drakes, but...
No, that's... pretty much non-starter for me.
Yeah, no, I'd replace one with, like, I don't know, like a Ysera or something, and replace the other with something lower.
Or even a Deathwing, the new Deathwing.
Oh, I kind of like that. All right, looks like we've got C'Thun Druid, which kind of ran rampant on the ladder not too long ago. Against this Tempo Warrior type thing of Alanon. He looks like he's running that as well. My greetings. It's to be honest, it's actually pretty popular in a lot of tournaments, so I can't be surprised.
Okay, the Winx is out.
Yeah, coin out the Winx, be ready for whatever he drops, pretty much.
Right. Yeah, and knowing Druid doesn't stock up on the breaker of the acid.
Okay. Oh right,
forgot.
Oh my gosh, why can't I think of it either? It's no. the cheap Harrison Jones that doesn't draw you cards.
Yeah. We're bad casters.
I know. And Acid Maw is completely the wrong card, but it's the only one I can think of.
Is the chat helping us?
I don't know. I think everybody's asleep in chat.
No, yeah. They're asleep.
Yeah, this isn't Twitch chat either, so they're not going to talk about legal. although I did actually have to say that in chat once, because, you know, I've seen some of these matches, and there's one of them where there was a clearly mislethal, and in Discord, I'm like, I don't want to be Twitch chat, but I'm just saying.
Mislead her, bruh. Okay. Good turn. Pull out that Elder?
Yeah, although it's vulnerable, right? I mean, we know he can drop a Ravaging...
No, it's T4. Yeah. But...
We know he can drop a Ravaging Gold Ping, but there's a lot of things in Warrior that can do extra damage like that. Although I guess you wouldn't expect...
The thing is, we need to sneak up some buffs to our C'Thun.
Right.
Yeah.
And you're not really going to get many that way.
Yeah, that's a non-starter, so...
I almost would have been better with him using the C'Thun, whatever the other one, the three mana 2/1 does 2 damage. Or I almost would have rather seen him use that.
Yeah.
Because it is also 3 mana. But you, it wouldn't have been as much of a downside if you lost it, right?
Yeah.
Oh, sorry, 1 second. Okay. The cat got in the room. I gotta let him out.
Hey. Hmm. Yeah, Rati. Rotting and hit. Okay.
Thy sleeper has awoken.
Oh, Sakram, huh? That's pretty much.
Okay, I'm back.
Yeah. He pulled out a Sakram cultist, which is.
Whoa!
Very much unplayed. First time I see it on play.
That's like, what's the 10/10 for 10? Eldritch Horror or something? You don't see that. It's, it feels like it's the same, just for C'Thun.
But hey, it hit him for 7.
No, oh, yeah, I mean, it's definitely like a big body, but it feels expensive for what you get.
And slide the cultists.
Yeah, you got 2 mana left. Might as well.
Yeah, beckoning. The beckoner.
Buff him. Buff that C'Thun.
First monkey.
Yeah, taunt trade. He's gonna taunt again, alright. I like it.
That's too much.
Well,
double taunt?
Oh my gosh, the purple drake there, I can't think of the real name. Azure Drake, sorry. Azure blue, drake. Not even purple. But you would think that he would trade that with the monkey. But then what, you would whirlwind? Yeah, I don't understand the logic.
Still. And still, they have a Doomcaller there, so...
Yeah,
double
C'Thun. Yeah, I was gonna say, I think in this situation you hold on to that Doom Caller until after you've put your C'Thun out.
And Grommash?
Yeah, Grommash should take out the Azure Drake.
Wow, mulch. Mulch that Grommash. Yes, mulch. Wow.
Dude,
that's
I love
pretty great card.
I know, yeah. I love these decks. These are awesome. This is what you get when you do an indie tournament like this. You get some awesome decks.
Yeah.
Well, here I was ready to expect just the standard C'Thun Druid I saw all over Ladder a couple months ago. And that's not really what this... I mean, it is, kind of. It's C'Thun Druid, but it's got some extra spice to it.
Wow, he's... I think he's brave now because he has a... Right?
I missed...
Sorry. I think he's brave now to pull out this C'Thun because he has a Doomcaller. Even though it dies, you can call him out later.
Yeah, I mean, are you putting him out? I mean, I suppose he's putting him out to hopefully clear up the board, but he didn't. So,
yeah. But still, he's still brave enough because Doomcaller means he still wins.
Right.
Oh, die.
Well, Doomcaller just shuffles him back into your deck, though, right? We're hardly at turn 10.
No, we were turn 10 already.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. We're just hitting turn 10. Doomcaller shuffles him back into your deck. You have to draw him again.
Yeah, but still, knowing his cards, yes, here.
But
everybody's
at 12 health. Or they were.
They were.
I'm just saying, I don't know if this game is going to last long enough for Doomcaller to matter. Because, I mean, you have Alanon put out his Ragnaros, and it hits the right target, and game over. Well, just about. Like, he needs to draw 3 more damage. Like, Or four, excuse me. Or no, three with the armorsmith. Which would be that monkey, although he can't play it now.
No. Oh! Thanks, RNG Jesus.
Yeah.
Says Wolf. Mulch.
Yep. Yeah, because you don't want to Spellbreaker him.
No.
I was just thinking, is there any reason not to mulch him? Yeah, no.
No.
Shadow Fiend, alright. I suppose that's pretty good, pretty good card to give your opponent if you have to give him one.
Oh, drop the Zod.
Yep. Well, you don't have Karen out yet.
Right, but...
Would you rather put Karen and the monkey out?
It doesn't have Death Rattles yet.
Oh, yeah. He hasn't had any.
Right.
I'm trying to think, and I don't think
it doesn't have one. Yeah.
I'm not sure if I like this. I might have put out Karen and the monkey knowing I have Nazoth in the hand.
What? Yeah, that's a weird drop on there. Oh, Ragnaros.
Now the Ragnaros tables have turned.
Yeah. Yet?
You know, never before in Hearthstone has there been so much Ragnaros.
No! He needs to swipe.
What? Yeah. Well, maybe he's... No, because even one of the armorsmiths is silenced. I was thinking maybe he's trying to not give him so much armor, but...
Armor, yeah, but still.
Yeah, this Frothing Berserker is going to make swipe not fun unless you just take out the Frothing Berserker, in which case you then give him all kinds of armor and... Yeah. I think... Alanon may have this locked up now.
Yeah.
Although, wait. No. Face swipe.
Oh, face swipe, yeah. 4/7
Oh, well, and actually, no, you couldn't do that either. You have to draw enough after that.
It's... Okay, that... Twin Empress.
So do you... Need to... Do you Twin Emp take out the Cairn? Okay, no. I like that actually. Yeah.
Yeah, Twin Vampires. Yeah.
Well, and you take out the frothing, so you don't have to worry about increasing damage on the board with other bullshit.
Does he break those? Does he need to break those emperors?
Well, I think he has to.
To armor up, right?
Man.
Yeah, it's such a bind.
You have to go through the emperors, because you have no other choice. But that destroys your board. And leaves you open to...
Ragnaros, right. That's why I'm... But because he doesn't know what comes to him,
Still, that's seven. You've only got 17 health. The druid only needs to come up with 10 more. Well, let's hope Nazoth saves your ass, because that's all you've got, yeah. Alanon.
Right. Time to draw Yolo Nazoth.
Yeah, it's GG at this point, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Well, I mean, that said, Whiskey Wolf's only got 9 damage on board. And if Nazoth comes out, Ragnaros is not a sure thing, so...
Yeah, just still praying with RNG Jesus, right? That's only one. So it's a 1/3 chance Ragnaros could kill you.
If you make this attack.
No, don't kill. Don't kill that.
Is he trying to set up for lethal, hoping that his N'Zoth will live?
His... Yeah, yeah. His...
That's...
No. But still...
I kind of think this is going to be Ragnaros end turn.
Yeah. It's a prayer.
Oh, maybe
Whoa,
not.
Whoa, what are you doing? He's taunting?
Maybe he doesn't want to risk.
He doesn't like the stakes. Yeah.
Yeah.
Or the probability of...
Yeah, this is probably better in the end. You have a better chance of locking it down.
Yeah.
That's true, G.
Need to slam... Oh, no. What?
Oh, not with that.
No.
I was gonna say it was GG if he cleared up the board, but that's not the case. There's another Doom Call.
Hey.
So I'm curious if C'Thun has died and
yeah.
you use Doom
Oh,
Caller,
YOLO.
Oh shit, never mind.
YOLO rag. One is one fourth chance.
Right, damn. 25% to win. I was just thinking, if you use... Okay, so C'Thun dies, right? You use Doomcaller. But you don't draw C'Thun before you use Doomcaller again. Are there two C'Thuns in your deck now?
No. If it's... The text says that if your your C'Thun dies... It draws up another one.
Right, but it has died. You just haven't drawn it back out.
No. So, yeah. If your C'Thun is still alive and you put on Doomcaller, it buffs it to 2/2.
Okay. I gotcha.
Okay, so we change up to a Priest. A Dragon Priest? Yeah, Dragon Priest.
Yeah, it certainly looks like it.
Greetings.
JC.
But this is the last deck he's got to win with, right? Because he's already up 2-0.
Yeah. 2-0.
Yeah, Whiskey Wolf's just burning him down.
Oh, man. Winx should be awesome here. But... No dice.
Yeah, sometimes you just don't draw it.
Yeah.
Yeah, all you can really do is nullify that 2 damage that's coming in. And hopefully waste his turn, but you're not gonna.
You see him.
That's always my sincerest hope against Priest, is that turn 2 they have to heal their own face at 30. I always love seeing that, because it makes me feel good.
Monkey for...
Yeah, I can't imagine why you would Ravaging Ghoul or Frothing Berserker. It doesn't. Neither one makes sense.
Yeah.
Because you put out the monkey and it can survive and kill both of those. You know.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. Oh, right.
Azure Drake. That's what he just picked
Azure
up.
Azure Drake, yeah. Unless he wants to...
Is this Museum Curator, Power Word Shield,
yeah,
Dean Drake?
Power Word Shield.
Or the,
yeah.
The Twilight Dragon, whatever that one is.
Oh, Shade?
Oh, you're going to coin Shade.
It's an iffy turn. For the Priest. That's
yeah, I kind of
right.
don't like that because then the warrior can just trade with your dragon.
Yeah. That's not right.
And yeah, this is going to happen. I mean, Temple Warrior has a lot of one damage board clear. I mean, having roots in being patron, that's kind of the name of their game.
Yeah. That's not a great turn for the Priest. now the priest has a bind here to forcefully kill the monkey.
Yeah, I almost wish it was turn 5 and I could Holy Nova.
Now, now the turn is to Museum Creator or heal the Shade.
Or do you Shadow Word that 3-3? Is that the right Shadow Word?
That's that.
Oh, okay, that's the... Okay.
Isn't that that? Yeah, it's that, not pain.
I think they're both 2 mana, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I thought so. So it's always hard for me to tell. And obviously, in this case, the game is pre-recorded, so I can't check.
Now, I could... Yeah, he could ping the... Right. Oh. Interesting.
Well, ping it with what?
No, the... What's this? What's this? This... The five spell card.
Oh, Holy Nova, yeah. But that would have only improved the Frothing Berserker because it wouldn't have killed it. Holy Nova only does 2 damage to opponents.
Right, but still, yeah, slam. Yeah, knowing the cards of the warrior, I'm just thinking, he should have Holy Nova did.
See, and I'm not sure about that because you leave yourself open to Frothing Berserker getting huge real fast.
But still, it's still lower than the one here, which is 7.
Probably.
Welcome to the exhibit. That thing. Since you're a dragon.
Yeah, might as well, right?
Winx. No. Maybe Karen.
Well, you frothing the... Yeah, you use the frothing on the dragon, and then you...
You could just... What's this? Execute.
Oh yeah. You could bump and execute with the Acolyte.
Yeah, execute the dragon and Karen.
I'm not sure if I like using execute on a 3-6, though. It's not not important. Right?
Still, he needs to bump his what's this? His minion count.
Yeah.
Because knowing his dragon priest, he needs to bump up his minions and kill all. Like that.
Yeah, kind of.
So, yeah, he should be killing that to execute, but still. It's turn.
Well, he doesn't have execute.
Before? He got it.
No, the priest didn't have it.
Oh, yeah, okay. But still.
No, he got battle rage from the Shade, I believe.
Shade, yeah.
I can't quite tell what that card is.
I think Chilmo.
Chilmo's not 5 mana.
7. Yes, Chilmo right there.
Oh, in the middle, yeah. No, I'm thinking the far left there on the top.
No, that's, I think...
Oh, Azure, okay. Yeah.
Azure.
And then he just drew another Shade.
Okay.
Do you trade?
Slam?
No, I think you... Yeah, I think you do this. You hit face with your Acolyte. And then you... Yeah. Oh, yeah, and you Battle Rage.
Battle Rage.
Smart.
Yeah, Battle Rage.
Yep, that's the way you do it.
Then Ravage.
Yeah, I probably would have missed the Battle Rage. And then, of course, you just, I mean, you might as well ping face with...
Yeah, Bloodhoof Battle Rage, yeah.
Yeah.
You're right.
And ping face with the Acolyte. I mean,
you're right, Eleanor. Kind of thinking this up. Pretty cool guy.
That was a very solid play.
Yeah, value.
Well, and this is like Trump. This is a big turn, right?
Not Trump. The Donald Trump. Yeah, Trump SC.
Yeah, Trump SC, the mayor of Value Town.
Yeah. Shilma. Yeah, don't tempt it. Knowing a Dragon Priest, it will kill.
Well, yeah, knowing a Dragon Priest, he's got the backup, but this isn't a threat.
Can we desert this out?
No, you don't have enough dead death rattles. This isn't a threat, though, right? Because you kill him and you execute, or you slam, or you...
Not execute, that's too much. Because knowing a Dragon Priest, there's Sarah.
Yeah, you do have two executes in your hand, but... I have no time for
games. Wow.
This comes down to... Do you value your second execute or do you value the card draw from slam? And it seems like he's valuing the card draw from slam.
Okay. Still.
Yeah, I mean, to be honest, I'm on the fence on that one. 50-50 either way, I'd have been...
For me, slam. Because execute's too much... It's so much value to kill.
Yeah, it's too easy to you know, like you say, put down Ysera, throw in your Armorsmith, and just execute.
Yeah. Okay. It's Ysera. No, you're now out of range. Yeah, Whiskey Wolf is a bind here.
He doesn't have anywhere to go. Like, he just...
9 plus 14, 15, Korkron. Yeah, Korkron.
Yeah, game over, right?
Yeah, game over.
Yeah, 4, 9, 10, 19. Done.
Yeah. Unless he wants to dance.
With what? Like, I mean, you're in a tournament, man. You finish the game.
Unless... This guy wants to dance.
What are you doing? No, Al-Anon. No! Stop that!
He wants to dance. Oh, no.
Stop that. Put it down.
Oh, no. He wants to dance.
No, that's even worse. I mean, props for originality, but no.
Oh. What are you doing? He wants to dance.
I mean, obviously he's thinking about slamming his Sylvanas to steal the shade, but like, you can finish the game. No, why wouldn't you attack before you slam it? Oh my god, this is killing me. Like, even if you're gonna kill your Sylvanas, why would you not attack with it first?
It's lethal already. What I know. Are you doing? He's billeting his opponent, I guess.
Extended BM. There is no missed lethal, there is only extended BM.
Still, he has Holy Nova.
Right, now he can, he can Blackwing Holy Nova and like get right back in this almost.
Yeah.
I mean, granted, Warrior's gonna have a lot of armor and you're gonna have a long way to go, but like, that's a significant turn. And if you're Al-Anon, like, you're kicking yourself in the ass if you miss lethal there.
Because
now you don't have it on board. Oh, no, you do, Grom.
Yeah, Gromish. But still, you're in a tournament, and you're BMing for what?
I'm not sure if he was BMing or if he just didn't see it.
See it, yeah.
I just...
But still...
What baffles me is the slam your Sylvanas without attacking with it. Why would you do that?
Yeah.
Man. All right, I think we need to take like about a 60-second break here. I need to run to the restroom real quick.
Sure, sure.
All right, I'll be right back. Keep everybody entertained.
Yeah, or play some tunes. Boom, boom. Okay. That time is... Hey. Listener. No. Uh-huh. Okay. Dum-dum-dum-dum. Stretching. Right. Now we'll look at some things here. Oh.
Okay, I have returned.
Thank you, Keeper of Grove. No, that's not right. Who says that?
What, Keeper of the Grove?
No, I forgot. I have returned. Is that a legendary?
StarCraft unit?
No, there's a card in Hearthstone that says that.
Oh, perfect. I have returned. And see, I mean, I know it's the Zealots in StarCraft, but...
No.
Your soul shall be mine.
But knowing that StarCraft reference, that's deep.
Oh yeah, there's been some conspiracy theories about Warcraft and StarCraft. And it wouldn't surprise me, right? Because they do root from the same place.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of stories about World of Warcraft and StarCraft.
StarCraft.
Or this...
StarCraft is Terran's? Oh, yeah, no. If Warcraft is Terran's home from the past?
Right. That's the idea, that right? Is that they exist in the same universe, just different timelines.
Yeah.
So it looks like we are Handlock of Alanon against...
Zoo.
Oh, I'm sorry. You're right. Totally Zoo. Against
and
the...
Dragon Priest.
Yep, Dragon Priest of Whiskey Wolf.
No. Yeah, skip.
I greet you.
Are you mocking me?
The old
Kinda.
Asshole clan, hello.
Yeah? That's why the answer of the... What's this? That 2-4 is perfect. Are you mocking me?
Yeah. I can't even remember what he's called.
Yeah. Yeah, dementia.
The problem is there's so many cards that are like just close enough.
It's like the problem with Magic cards. That, you know, that card that...
Yeah, that I more know what they do than what...
Yeah. What's the thought here? No. Why? No, why? Why
are you
doing
throw
that?
Out? No, okay, Defender.
But still, that's not good. Supposed to be Ink Gap boss, right?
I don't know. I guess I'd have been happy with either. It's kind of 50-50 there for which is better.
Well, yeah, but... It's kind of... Now Ink Gap boss.
Yeah.
Villager.
Save your pillager for your Dark Shard councilman.
That Dark Shard.
more dragons coming out.
Yeah, it's pretty hard to take out.
Oh, now you're in a pickle. Because you can't take out that dragon.
No.
Do you just start building up your Darkshire? Because you can coin out Imp Gang Boss, too. Or
five. No, that's not it.
No, I mean, you could coin out Abusive Sergeant, is what I meant, but...
Yeah.
Oh, no. Oh, Abusive Sergeant.
Direwolf,
yeah.
Direwolf, Abusive Sergeant. Yeah.
That's how you take him out.
Get in there, fight, maggot!
Still one off. One. Still.
Right, but you don't die. And you generate that 1-1.
Does he pull out? No, Murray. Oh, ooh. Yeah.
That stinks.
Okay. I think the priest has taken over the board and now it's scramble time.
Yeah, the warlock has got to get back because if a Zulok loses their board, it's pretty much done unless they can make it back in 1 to 2 turns.
And knowing that the guy has this 5 mana, what's this?
Blackwing Corruptor?
Blackwing, yeah, Corruptor. You're pretty much fucked.
Yeah, there's not a lot you can put out that he's going to care about.
He lowered their chances there.
Yeah, you don't want to put out a Darkshire on this naked board. All right. Yeah.
No,
I mean, to be honest.
Raptor, yeah. That's 3. That's 8.
Yeah, but, I mean, ending turn there for Alanon is...
Oh, no.
As acceptable GGs. As anything else. No. Yeah, this is game over.
That's fast. That's fast.
Turn 7? It'll be over?
Yeah, turn 7.
I mean, unless Alanon concedes, you know, then it's turn 6.
But no, he doesn't know he has Holy Nova, Whiskey Wolf.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Look at what he's got on board.
Yeah, but still, that's 5, 10, yeah.
Yeah.
I have extra BM.
Yeah, there you go.
Holy Nova. Oh, all right. That's fast.
Yeah, that was definitely a fast one, so.
Okay. Not much to say with that.
So wait, that was game 3. Yeah. No, that Whiskey Wolf takes that match.
Yeah.
Let's see. We are next headed to, I believe, Sir... Spaff and Whiskey Wolf? Is that where I went next? All right, let me see here. I don't remember who I did next. I gotta jump forward in time. Because we had a couple people not show up, so.
But still, it's still 11, right?
No, there was only like 6 that actually read, that actually checked in.
Wow.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yeah, that actually checked in. Of the total of 10 that were signed up, so. More than 50%, yeah. I guess, you know.
Well. Still a start.
Well, yeah, and that happens, right? People forget the tournament happens, things like that. That's why there's a wait list. You
asked for it. A dragon, yeah. Whiskey Wolf's dragon mage.
So yep, now we're at the next match down the line where we're at Spaff, who had basically a buy through Hoopy Hobo who didn't check in, to now face Whiskey Wolf who won the game that we just watched. Yeah. Yep.
Okay, solid drop.
And as far as who's on the top and the bottom of the screen, I tried to kind of switch it up with people, but, you know, like this turn, I knew Whiskey Wolf was at the top last time, so he's at the bottom this time.
Interesting turn. Why coin it out?
Because it can't be directly answered.
But still, that's a weird turn.
Not really. I mean, I agree because you don't have a turn two, other than Pink Face.
Yeah, but yeah, knowing this.
Well, yeah, for us knowing that there's Doomsayer, it sucks because there's nothing you can do here other than face. But face. You can take solace in the fact that he's not going to be drawing any cards.
Yeah,
because those goddamn whatever they are, 1/3s that draw you cards. I hate those. That's how the priest gets off to an early lead.
Right. Ping.
I might even think about developing a Forgotten Torch, just sure. So you have it for later.
Burn him to 3. Yeah.
Just hit him for 3. He might heal, whatever. But now you've got that 6/3 in your deck.
But yeah, knowing card management, yeah.
To be honest, again, I'd have been happy either way there. I'd probably say, yeah, I understand the Forgotten Torch to the face, and yeah, I also understand just the ping.
Right. Yeah, so non-commit there.
Man, this is a serious dragon mage deck. It's not like a tempo mage with some dragons. It's a dragon mage.
No, dragon mage.
And the mana worm just doesn't happen to have the label of dragon on it, which it almost should, but it's also an ethereal creature.
So. No, it's a Blizzard's thing. Because down the line, they know that mana worm is kind of strong.
Yeah.
If it does two things. It's a dragon,
but it's also it's also not really a dragon because it's not really real.
Yeah, knowing the lore, but
yeah,
still, Worm is a dragon too.
Well, right. Yeah.
Is someone injured?
So he's gonna develop the Northshire Cleric and Power World Shielder. That way you just can't be taken out by the Twilight Guardian that came out.
Heal the face. Oh, no. Well, he just...
Yeah, you drop the Black Moon Corruptor and then trade, and he's got no board. And, I mean, as the Dragon Mage, you know this is the Dragon Priest because you've played it... Oh, wait, no. This is Spaffin Whiskey Wolf. Sorry, I'm thinking back to Al-Anon. Who... Didn't he also have... Dragon Mage? Or
this one, yeah.
Oh no, Whiskey Wolf was the one with Dragon Mage. Okay.
Okay, great turn
swapped
for the
around.
Piece. Yeah, great turn for the
piece. And that's a natural death Deathwing Dragon Lord. I didn't realize he had that in his deck.
Right.
Alright.
Alright, yeah.
No, I like it. I want to see that card, because, I mean... For instance, if he were to put it out and it were to die right now, 4 dragons hit the board. And not insignificant dragons either. 2 of them 8/8.
Okay.
Oh, damn. And add more big, heavy dragons to your hand. I mean, like, to be honest, Spaff is kind of lucky it's not turn 10, because I guarantee you that Deathwing would come out right now.
Right. Uh-huh. 4.
As it is, he's going to try to turn the board around. Yeah. And it looks like from that ancient, Spaff got a... What is it? Arcanian Elect. And he has now drawn his map, so... I mean, do you start trying
either
to...
Either you want to... Okay.
I would almost want to excavate an evil here, just to... Yeah,
excavating evil, yeah.
Clean up
maybe
the board.
Next turn, yeah. Maybe next turn map, then a minion if he draws some. But that hurts.
You've got a lot of healing to do, man. And your Nzoth doesn't feel good because you don't have any death rattles.
Yeah, you need to map now.
Even then, you have 8 damage for sure coming in next turn, and you can pretty much count on
another
6.
Now, yeah. second death, then map. Because you need to draw a minion still.
Yeah, yeah, and at least the map will get you another card.
Yeah. I'm the map. Sorry, Dora fans. You know you like that.
I used to watch that with my sister.
Wow.
When she was little. Well, you know, babysitting and shit. Anything to keep the kid happy, but... There's that Deathwing. I mean, if he...
It's not scary.
If he deaths... No. Oh, game over, Saf. That... Like, normally, you know, Shadow Word Death on that Deathwing is the right thing to do, but, no.
Yeah. Great answer.
Yeah, because 99% of the time you think taking out a 12-12 with Shadow Word Death is the thing to do, but in this situation, it just lost you the game. Because that's, 14, 18, and... Oh, 7 and 3. Yeah, you're done. It's 28 right there.
Whiskey Wolf 1, Spaff 0.
Yep, Whiskey Wolf 1, Spaff 0. Try to goose it along a little here. Too far. Nope, too far back. Okay, I'm not good at this.
Kind of.
Okay, perfect.
I think we need to, after this match, have another thing here. So we could part two it in the morning?
Oh yeah, you want to do a break after this match and then do the other half tomorrow?
Yeah.
Yeah, absolutely.
So yeah, recorded. You can listen to it if someone's watching.
Yeah, something.
Emote. What ifs emote? Phil Limmerton. Yeah, great turn.
Well, he's got this aggro paladin, it looks like, right? Divine Shield aggro thing?
Or Divine Paladin. Yeah, Divine Shield Paladin.
I guess I always just classify the Divine Shield one as aggro because it seems, you know, really, really. You know, there really kind of are no weak classes now. I mean, people rag on Priest, but it's not that weak.
No. Not at
all. It's not like Shaman was.
If you have a great turn out on your hand, that will be good.
Right.
If you have the great hand to have.
Except mice.
Not that great on that one drop. Because he the rogue can kill it and still double buffs that either of them. It's just a wasted turn.
Yeah, no. Don't fan of knives this. Yeah.
No. Yeah, kill that, then fan of knives.
Then fan to get rid of it.
What?
No, because then he's gonna I don't like that at all. Because see, he still ended up attacking.
Yeah. Don't worry, loves. The cavalry's here.
Well, what are you going to do here, Spaff? The thing is, right, is that the Paladin Whiskey Wolf, he's got board control, but he's got no cards. He's got nowhere to go from here.
No board, yeah.
And it's not even like his board control is that great.
Refreshment just to be alive?
Well, I mean, you're not too scared of dying yet. Like, do you have something to develop there? It's kind of hard to tell with the cards that small.
No. No, that's not a thing. That's not a thing. Well, still a thing, but still in the red because of your life.
I mean, I guess you can still, at this point, put out Refreshment Vendor next turn, but now you're kind of wasting a mana. I mean, since Refreshment Vendor's 4, what are you going to do with that extra mana next turn?
That's a weird card pulled out.
I was trying to figure out what that card was because I couldn't tell from the art, but I've seen it here and there in Ladder. It's just not in Rogue. Huh. All right. The really interesting part about that is it gives Rogue a source of heal, which you don't usually have.
Yeah, but that's not a great card in the long road for it.
But maybe not in the long run, but situationally, it's actually not bad.
If you want to replace your, what's this, the 3-3...
Oh, Earthen Ring Farseer.
Earthen Ring Farseer, yeah.
Yeah, because especially in this position, he can then use that to trade off for the Sir Finley, and it still takes both of those Morgans to kill him.
Okay. He wants a double here.
Okay.
Yeah, it's a double heal.
You know what? And to be honest now, he's ahead.
Yeah, it's a crafty.
Yeah.
It's a crafty thing.
That's smart.
Yeah, he could. Not the one? Why?
Wait. Yeah, there's not a one for one?
Why?
Because.
Hey, wait.
Am I
it's supposed to be zero, yeah.
I'm right, right? Shadowcaster she's the 1-1 for one thing.
Yeah. If you shadow, what's this? It's a weird thing.
So
it's supposed to be.
Why wouldn't you shadow step that?
You're
supposed
totally to be zero.
Right.
Yeah.
Because then that's another 6 heal or whatever, because it's 3-3 each, right? So it's another 6 heal for 3 or 4 if it's 2. I don't remember. Again, we don't see that card that often. I don't play that card that often.
Leroy abusive just to push damage.
I mean, I guess Leroy abusive hero. It's 10 to the face. I mean, what are you gonna do? Can take out the Leroy next round, but it's also, well, I guess I shouldn't say it's easy for the paladin to drop face damage.
Yeah, that guy.
More healings.
Yeah,
Paladin's in a dire spot. Oh, if he's gonna gang up this refreshment vendor.
Gang up
like
the refreshment vendor.
Ooh.
That's awesome.
I like that play. I think you should do that. Yeah.
Yeah. More help for you,
right? And especially since you're clearing off their board and they've got no cards in hand, you probably feel kind of comfortable because you can start drawing those.
Mm-hmm. Right. Yeah. Taunt. Yeah. Drop this guy.
Oh, and this is nothing.
And face. Yeah.
You know, right now the Paladin's saving grace is that he's got that hero power.
Yeah. Combo the Oracle.
Oh, yeah, Oracle combo Shadow Step Oracle? No, you don't want even cards.
No, Oracle just with the SI agent.
Oh, I see. Combo him that way. Sorry, not combo like a mill deck. That's what I was saying. I was like, why would you all of a sudden turn into a mill deck? He has no cards.
No. Okay. Okay. That works too.
Yep. Yeah. And throw him right back out.
Throw him back in. Yeah. Combo that.
And then make up for the four. Make up for the four health you gave him. Yeah. This has turned right on around.
Yeah.
Spaff was
not close.
No. Spaff was up against the wall.
Yeah, alright.
Ah, Whiskey Wolf. Yep. He's like, I can't draw anything.
Okay.
Alright, 1-1.
Right. 1-1. Yeah, after this hard stop, I need to go to my other thing.
Oh, yeah, what time is that?
That's 30.
So 25 minutes?
Yeah.
Okay. Maybe we should stop now.
Oh, okay. It's a long match, right?
Yeah.
Right.
Should we stop at 1-1? Leave the suspense?
Yeah, suspense and not full hard on.
Full hard on?
With the match. Yeah, full hard on. It's supposed to be this thing, but yeah, limited at this.
Oh, that's too funny. All right. So, yeah, thanks for joining us, everyone.
Yeah, sorry for the unprofessional of this cast.
Hey, if you're on Diamond Club and you expect professional, you're in the wrong place. This works out perfectly because we're at an hour 55 and there are 4 hours and 1 minute. I should say 4 hours and 2 minutes. So we're right at the middle.
Yeah, maybe we need to cut it up into two parts.
Yeah, it's long. But
right,
as I was saying, thanks for joining us.
Yeah, thanks.
We'll be back. What do you think? Tomorrow morning for me?
Yeah, morning. That would be great. Sunday morning?
Yeah.
Watching some streams of guys missing Lita. pretty good day.
I mean, I know how good Twitch chat feels. Like, come on.
Yeah, but still, that five.
We've all been there. I mean, I have definitely.
BM if you have that thing in front of you.
Well, I mean, no BM even. I've been so focused on, like, say, clearing the board or whatever that I don't notice that I have lethal until I hit end turn and I go, oh, shit, that extra five damage could have gone to face, huh? You know?
Right. Still, we could ask him outright after this. Hey, did you do that thing with Sylvanas? Is it a BM? Or not?
Yeah, you never know. So, but anyway, thanks for joining us. We will be back in a few hours. You know, and RR will still be awake. I'm gonna sleep and then wake up again. So,
yeah, I'm awake. I'm awake.
I swear. All right. Thanks for joining us.
Yeah,
and
thanks.
We'll see you tomorrow.